This video presents an overview of R80.10 policy installation steps, flow, and troubleshooting. The policy installation is a complex procedure which can be simplified into several steps and components. The GUI or user interface is a smart console that is installed on a client computer. The smart console securely connects to the security management server, reads the database, and displays it. In case any change is made on policy rules, objects, or any global setting, it will be saved to the Postgres database on the security management after the administrator publishes the change. The first step of the policy installation is initialization. This can be done by selecting to install policy on Smart Console or from the Management API. After the initialization, the following steps are taking place on the security management side. Step 2. Verification. First, the system settings are verified. It checks if the user has the right permissions for policy installation, verifies that no other policy installation is in progress, and checks some other settings. Step 3 is database dump. In this step, the security management CPM process dumps the Postgres SQL database into file format. In step 4, modern conversion, the security management FWM process converts the database files to a new format and places them in the following path. In step 5, conversion and verification is done per layer. It verifies that the information in the database complies to a number of rules specific to the application and package for which the policy installation is requested. Next, the policy files are copied to the $fwdir/state/gateway-name directory on the management server. In step 6, the file is transferred between the security management and the security gateway. First, secure internal communications, SIC, is negotiated. Once it succeeds, the files are sent to the gateway, and the gateway confirms that it received all the files. Step 7 is cogeneration and compilation of new files on the security gateway side, which loads the file information to the local SQL database. Step 8 of the policy installation is the commit, which is performed on the security gateway. In this step, the CPD process on the gateway verifies that all the files were transferred and calls the following fwfetchlocal command. This command loads the policy into the kernel. If this process completes successfully, the files are copied to the $fwdir/state/local/fw1 directory. In case the fwfetch process fails, the CPD will notify the security management's FWM process that the policy load on the module has failed and send a reason. In step 9, finalization, after the policy has been installed on the security gateway and notification received, the CPM process on the security management is updated with a policy status. The CPM performs DB load with the new information. In order to troubleshoot policy installation, we first have to understand which step has failed. All the steps can be divided into three main stages: verification and compilation, which takes place on the security management; transfer, which involves both the security management and the security gateway; and commit, which takes place on the security gateway. Troubleshooting is different in each one of these stages. To troubleshoot verification and compilation errors on the security management server, the first step is to check the Smart Console error message. There are cases in which the error is clear and points to a specific problem that can be solved by the administrator. If the error is not clear, search for it online in Checkpoint Support Center. When more information is needed, you can search for it in the Install Policy log file. Connect with SSH to the Security Management Server. The log file name is installpolicy.elg and is located in the firewall log directory. The file collects information also when debugging is not enabled. You can copy the file from the Security Management Server to your desktop PC and view it with a text editor. Or you can search for it on the server itself with the built-in viewing and editing tools. Running the following grep command to search for a string in the file, we receive a summary of the messages and can see the message about the policy verification failure. Here we can copy a string that will make the search in the file easier. In this case, we use the VI editor to open the log file. We search the string we copied before until we reach the relevant part. Basically, browsing from here onward or back in time will give us more information regarding the failure that happened. There are cases, however, when the default log level of installpolicy.elg does not give us enough information about the failure. The two main processes which are responsible for verification and compilation on the security management are CPM and FWM. To get a more detailed output, we want to enable these processes in debug mode. Following are the steps to enable in the CPM debug. Change directory to the $fwdir/conf directory. Backup the tdlog.cpm file. Open the file with VI editor and search for the following string. Install policy equal info. On the log level, install policy equal line. Change the info to debug. Save and close the file. This time, when we install policy, we receive debug information in the installpolicy.elg file. We have downloaded the file to our workstation and opened it with a text editor to make the search easier. We search for the first occurrence of verification failed and check above it if we can see the reason. In this case, the log file does not reveal any useful information. The second main process that is important in the policy load is FWM. Running FWM load for debug, as we have done in previous versions, will not work in R80.10. In order to get it to work, enter the following export line. Now we can run FWM load from command line using the following syntax. This will load the policy in debug mode. To check if the policy load completed, run tail-f on the output file name to see the data that is added to the file. If no more data is written, it means the load is completed. we open the debug output file with a text editor and search for the phrase "verification failed." Here we see again the internal error occurred log, which actually is the message FWM sent to the CPM. Browsing up a little, we can see the cause of this failure, which is FWM unable to read the file asm.c, which is required for the verification. To summarize this video, we have seen the flow and steps of R80.10 policy installation. The steps can be divided into three main stages: verification and compilation, which take place on the security management; file transfer between the security management and the security gateway; and policy commit, which is done on the security gateway. The first step of troubleshooting an issue is to identify the stage in which the policy installation failed. To troubleshoot the verification and compilation steps, we have demonstrated how to run the CPM and FWM processes in debug mode. In the next video, we will demonstrate troubleshooting of the file transfer stage. Thank you for watching.